and welcome to the 12th annual Megan McCarthy Fashion Show. My name is Amanda Leone, and alongside me is my partners Ava Gilligan and Jack Sadman, and we are your co-partners and hosts for this evening.
Also, along with our DECA chapter, we're extremely excited this year to make the show possible. We're able to have an amazing show this evening, and we're keeping our goal in mind to keep as much awareness for Megan and who she was and her legacy at the school.
Now, who is Megan? Oh, wow, that's very loud. Okay. Megan McCarthy was a student here at Tewksbury Memorial High School who was diagnosed with glioblastoma, all type 1, inoperable brain tumor. She was told she would have anywhere from 2 weeks to 2 years to live and still attended all 4 years of high school and participated in several sports such as field hockey and basketball. There was never a time where Megan slowed down. On January 10th, 2010, Megan received her diploma. And unfortunately, on January 19th, Megan's battle against cancer had come to an end, but is still never forgotten.
Tonight is for Megan, as we share her memories and remember her. However, we could not portray Megan as well as others, which is why many of the stories you'll be hearing tonight come directly from Mrs. Lee McCarthy, Megan's mom, and her best friend, Lauren Walsh.
Before we begin tonight's show, we would like to extend our thank yous to everyone who's made the show possible. First of all, thank you to our stores, Ultimate, Glitterati, David's Bridal, Escala, Sally's Tuxedo, for offering us these dresses and tuxes so we can fancy as we do. And thank you to our models for raising as much money as you did for participating, and for the volunteers for hair and makeup, who made us all look nice and treated.
And now it is my honor to introduce our DECA advisor and former teacher of Megan's, Mr. Sullivan.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much. Thank you, Ava, me, and Jack. I'm here to give out some thank yous here early on, and then later on tonight, try to do my best and keep it together and talk to you about Megan. But first of all, I need to thank Ava, me, and Jack, who really have done an unbelievable job this year. I know I say that every year, but they're panicking all day today as we're getting ready for the show. And I'm like, yeah, don't worry about it, it's all set. And they're like, yeah, but we're nervous. But don't need to be nervous, you've done all the work. And so they've done an incredible amount of work this year, the three of them. They've really done a fantastic job. We've been fortunate year after year to have great people, great kids, great students that have led this show and this program. And that tradition in history keeps going on and on. And that continued again this year. So. I want to give them a big round of applause, and if you could all give them a huge round of applause. I need to thank our administration, especially here at the high school, and Mr. Bernard, who's been on board, Dave, since day one, with us being able to have the show. I know, again, there's some difficulties here a little bit with the requirements, but they are what they are, and they're set forth by people much higher than us here in the town of Tewksbury. So we're getting there, we're all hanging in there. I appreciate your help and us being able to do this because, as Mia said, we're all here for Megan. And so, you know, I wasn't gonna be able to do this without talking about Megan early. So, you know, these things are brutal, right? Like, they're tough on you, they're tough on me, they're tough on the kids. But at the end of the day, well, we're wearing a mask. And why are we here today? We're here today for Megan McCarthy, for a student that was here at Tewksbury High School that was diagnosed with a brain tumor as a freshman. And for 3.5 years of her life, she went through chemotherapy, she went through radiation, she went through experimental treatment after experimental treatment to keep her life alive. And she got up every single day and came to Tewksbury High School, it came to school, and she went to field hockey practice, and she went to basketball practice, and that was after days that she had to go to children's to get those treatments. So if we have to wear a mask
You make the sip one person a pot, so be it. That guy went through more than any one of us has to this point in our lives, hopefully, for all of you that are here. So I'm sorry that you have to do it, but please keep that in mind. Understand that that's why we're here. We are here for Megan. This group of kids, this group of students, those three leaders, Jack and me and Ava, completely understand it. And they get that. And so that's why this has been so great to get us to this point. So again, to our administration that's been so helpful, Mr. Bernard, who's theoretically been here for 20 minutes, you know, last year and this year on an interim basis, he has bought right into what this is and what this show and what this night is all about. So I have to thank him. And then to our students and all of you that are here tonight that have helped get them to here, and I have this statement every year that I didn't tell you children to go home and ask you for $50 on October 27th. Because I know on October 28th in the morning, some of you were asked for a check. We had a meeting early in the school year. We were more organized than ever this year. We gave the kids out a flyer that deck of dues are $85, community passes $50, which by the way, they're breathing down my neck on a few of you. So if you could get that squared away, I'd really appreciate that, including my wife. She answers that, but that's not my comment. I got the leaves on today, all the landscaping did that time. So. But I know it's a big financial ask, and every kid has paid their dues. We gotta get those community pass things squared away. A lot of you have, and thank you for that. And then to ask for a minimum of $50 to be in the show, I tried to spread it out, honestly. I didn't ask for that all on that October 28th. So that's a conversation you can have with your kid. But some of the kids have done unbelievable. And with your help, through your Facebook accounts, because I'm friends with a lot of you, through their own social media accounts, putting it out there and getting people to donate, it's really been tremendous. Again, the minimum to be in the show this year was $50. At this point, I would like to recognize those students. We've always kind of had a standard of $200. If you raise more than $200, we would call you up on stage, and that number is usually like 4, 5, or 6 people. This year, that number is 19. That's due to them and to you. So I don't want to pretend that you haven't played a big role in that. You all have, so thank you for that. So let me announce our top fundraisers, and we will start with $200 with Emily Pitcher. Come on out, Emily. And then $220, Ava Fernandez, who is actually out playing in our state championship volleyball game right now as we speak. So, $240, Courtney Curtin and Erin Costello. $245, Maya Melke. $250, and please hold, I have 4 or 5 people on this list. So, Jillian Mantel, Dakota Malicia, Michael Connors, and Lauren Connors. And that's $250 each. Michael and Lauren were a tag team for a total. They were $250 each, so great job. $5, Anne Marie Sullivan. $290, Alexis Waterworth. $300, Jack Statman and Emily Mitchell. $325, Mia Gaglione. We jump to $405, Olivia Capello.
$420, Alex Makata. $470, Aliana Kennan. $500, only a freshman, Reese Maniscalco. $585, also only a freshman, Ava Kanaxis. $660, and that number has an asterisk because she also got another check for $1,000 donation on the side of that. One of our directors, Ava Gilligan. Another freshman, now this is gonna date me, not her mom, whose mom actually ran this show for the Muscular Dystrophy Association years ago, Olivia Ronan. And I'm pretty sure I forgot to say that she was $717. Fundraiser at $875, Trisha Woodford. Congratulations, gang. Great job. We had 71 students registered for DECA this year, which is a pretty good number, especially coming out of COVID. We had 61 participating in the show. We had three more people that were volunteering outside that also raised money and said, oh no, we don't want to be in the show. We just wanted to raise money and we wanted to volunteer. So 64 people total out of our 71 DECA students have participated, which is 90%, which is fantastic. If you take those 64 people divided by the staggering amount of $11,370 that they brought in just in model money to be in the show, the average amount raised in those 64 people was $177.64. Amazing. Last two things here, all of the money raised tonight will be going to the Megan McCarthy Research Fund again to help benefit those in need and to help continue research on brain and pediatric cancer so that hopefully we can try and get this thing fixed and that other people like Lee and oh so many that have dealt with young children with cancer and anybody with cancer can try and be helped along and solve here. So without further ado, I pass the microphone off to Ava. The only thing that I didn't say earlier that I should have, the one concession that we were given is that when students were speaking at the microphone, Mr. Bernard did say it was okay for them to take their mask off as we did the other day with speakers at the Veterans Day ceremony. I can speak loud enough. I probably don't even need the microphone, but so I didn't do it. But for them, please understand that's why they are allowed to do that. So we appreciate your help and your patience and everything you've done. So thank you.
We also like to thank Dana-Farber and the Jimmy Fund for sponsoring tonight's event. Our connection with them has allowed us to make this show the best it can be. And this year, we've raised the most model money than ever before. And it's amazing to see all the hard work and dedication that I've earned. Tonight is all about Megan. One of the many clubs that Megan was a part of during high school was DECA. Our DECA chapter hosts this amazing event tonight. Being a part of Team HSDECA, there was no doubt that Megan was a leader, always putting others before herself and dedicating so much time into helping others, even though she was facing one of the most tough, difficult battles of her life. In honor of Megan being a part of DECA, we would first like to introduce our category of the night, business. So with that being said, let's get down to business.
As I'm lying next to someone else.
Jack Stebbins, as previously introduced. A big part of Megan's life was sports. Throughout her life, you could find Megan on some sort of field or court. Joining us today are some of her high school coaches, Pat Lazer, her field hockey coach, and Coach Bradley, her basketball coach. Big round of applause. There you go. All of her teammates were alongside Megan from the very beginning and made her feel like part of the team, no matter the circumstances. Growing up, Megan participated in many sports such as travel soccer, since a young age, playing basketball for both her high school team and travel team, and finally field hockey. With all this action on the field, there was no doubt Megan was strong and a fighter. Hanging up on our gym in the high school are two jerseys that belong to Megan. The number 28 will never be worn by another field hockey player at Team HS ever again, as will the number 24 for basketball. Megan's jerseys are the only numbers that will ever be that are ever retired in Cooksburg. Her jerseys are framed in the gym at Team HS and serve as a constant reminder for Megan and how much she meant to this community, but it's also a reminder of how strong she was. I would like to introduce our next category, the athletic category. We'll see many of our models repping their Tewksbury athletic gear to symbolize Megan's love for Tewksbury sports. So now, take it away, athletics.
Oh!
Yeah.
Teaching us every day that presents us with another opportunity to pursue greatness, to achieve in the face of adversity, and to inspire others to demonstrate those qualities. Megan was granted her angel wings on January 19, 2010. However, her story and the impact she has had on others does not end there. On February 5th, 2010, Megan was posthumously recognized as an honored athlete at the 2010 Massachusetts Celebration of Women in Sports Day at Faneuil Hall. In March of 2010, she was posthumously nominated as a basketball all-star for the Merrimack Valley Conference. And in June of 2010, she was posthumously awarded the Terry Lightfoot Inspiration and Courage Award. Her legacy continues through the annual presentation of the Megan McCarthy Tewksbury Tough Coaches Award, awarded to the female athlete who represents the finest qualities of fair play, work ethic, perseverance, and athletic excellence, and also through awarding of various scholarships. But more importantly, her legacy continues through the funds raised by the DECA Fashion Show. And also through field hockey's annual Play for the Cure, and also by the team Flying Henrys of the Pan Mass Challenge, who have contributed to the Megan McCarthy Research Fund for the last 12 years also. But the fight must go on. Since the beginning of this year, more than 13,000 people have been diagnosed with glioblastoma. Also known as GBM, the most complex, treatment-resistant, and deadliest type of brain cancer. GBM accounts for 47% of all primary malignant brain tumors. This tumor type can affect anyone at any age, including children. This is the type of tumor that Megan had. Also, you probably have heard of John McCain, Ted Kennedy, Bo Biden, and most recently, Vice President of Public Relations, Heather Walker of the Celtics. Today, more than 13,000 children are living with a brain tumor in the United States, and 3,700 more will be diagnosed this year. Glioblastoma can affect men, women, and children. It does not discriminate based on age, gender, or ethnicity. The glioblastoma patient population is in desperate need of new and better therapeutic options. Despite first being identified in scientific literature in the 1920s, there have been only four drugs and one device ever approved by the FDA for the treatment of glioblastoma. Survival rates for patients with glioblastoma have not significantly improved in nearly 40 years. Glioblastoma is one of the most expensive cancers and indeed diseases to treat. Patients typically require a broad spectrum of specialty care. including brain surgery, repeated MRIs, radiation, chemotherapy, rehabilitation, steroids, anti-epileptic drugs, physical and or occupational therapy, and palliative care. Dana-Farber and the Megan McCarthy Research Fund are passionately committed to brain tumor patients and care partners, putting GBM patients first and working to meet the needs of all those in the brain tumor community. Progress made within the brain tumor community helps other cancer patients as well, because the knowledge gained can be shared with researchers across all cancer types. With your support, we can offer incredible new hope for improved treatments and a better quality of life for all those impacted by all types of cancer. And if you've been listening to the news in the last 2 weeks, you heard that Heather Walker of the Celtics was just given her first dose of the new vaccine called Neovax, using her own immunotherapy to try to fight the glioblastoma that she has been diagnosed with. This is amazing news for people in the brain tumor community. Thank you for supporting the Megan McCarthy Research Fund, patients and care partners, helping to empower the cancer community. And as famous songwriter Janis Danfield said, "I cannot do all the good that the world needs, but the world needs all the good that I can do." Thank you.
She was diagnosed with inoperable glioblastoma multiforme on June 4th of 2007, the summer after our freshman year of high school. On January 19th, 2010, Megan lost her courageous battle with cancer. She received her angel wings and was taken from all of us. As a 14-year-old, you can imagine it certainly was not easy news to hear. But Megan wanted to keep her life as normal as possible throughout her treatment. For the next 2.5 years, she continued to be a three sport athlete, go to school, go on vacations, hang out with her friends, and eventually graduate high school. Yes, there are times that she missed classes and practices and games, but through it all, she did it with a smile, and truly, she remained to very tough. I would personally like to thank her mom, Lee, her family, teachers, and her coaches for allowing her to simply be a normal teenager. When I started writing this speech, I honestly had no idea where to start. I remember Stella said to me in previous years, "What has Megan taught you and how has she impacted you?" Now, that truly is not the easiest question to answer, because she honestly has completely changed my life. Meg taught us all different things. She taught us to be strong and to face every day as a new day. No matter what struggles you are facing, it can always be worse, and unfortunately, there is likely someone who is having a worse day than you. She taught us to smile through the tears and appreciate life, because not everyone gets as much time as they should. She taught us to live in the moment and to not focus on the past. When someone passes away so young, it's easy to dwell on the experiences that she didn't have. Megan didn't get to experience her senior prom. She didn't get to experience college, have her first legal drink, watch her brothers get married, meet her nieces and her nephews. She didn't have the opportunity to be in her friends' weddings and see them start their own families. It truly is easy to get held up on all the things that she missed out on and not focus on what she was actually able to accomplish. She had the opportunity to meet the Jonas Brothers at Kiss concert, go on a road trip to Chicago, toss the opening pitch at a spinner's game, and attend a beauty weekend and photo shoot with other patients at Dana-Farber. But I think two of her favorite memories would be to be invited to a spring training trip with the Jimmy Fund, which allowed her to meet her absolute idol, Dustin Pedroia, and her Make-A-Wish trip to Atlantis, where she got to swim with the dolphins. Now, those of you who got the opportunity to know Meg, she loved to be the center of attention. There are many times throughout her fight that she became that center. Through multiple fundraisers, news articles, dedicated sporting events, and even school dances. She was invited to speak at the Jimmy Fund's Par for the Cure Golf Classic in 2009. She was chosen as one of Wilson's 25 most fascinating people of 2008. She was chosen to be Stop and Shop's triple winner and became the poster child from the Jimmy Fund from April to July of 2008. And I kid you not, you cannot go into a Stop and Shop store and not see her face plastered everywhere. Now, I also have the privilege of being the administrator for Megan's Miracles Facebook page. A couple of years ago, I got a message from someone I had never met before. She was also a patient at Dana Farber and had gone on a couple trips with Megan and the Jimmy Fund. Her message has truly stuck with me. She said, "I only knew Megan for a brief period of time, but in the times we spent together at the Jimmy Fund retreat, she, along with a handful of other girls, brought me a few days of laughter and the relief from the horrors of treatments. I will never forget our time together. Thank you, Megan, for being such a bubbly person and helping others see the joys in life, even in the darkest of times." It's easy to see how Megan has impacted Tewksbury in such a strong way, but it's truly amazing to see how she impacted every single person that she interacted with. Megan was a gifted individual, and one that exemplified all that is right in a very unforgiving world. You see, Megan created a legacy. Megan's awareness for cancer, and she was involved in multiple fundraising events. She was chosen as the Pan Mass Challenge Pedal Partner. The Pan Mass Challenge Pedal Partner Program connects a patient at Dana-Farber and with a riding team. She was lucky enough to be selected for the Flying Henrys. Through their dedication and connection, the Flying Henrys have raised over $1.1 million for Dana-Farber and the Jimmy Fund since 2008. Starting just 3 months after her passing, the Megan McCarthy Memorial Walk and Run was held every March for the next 10 years. This fashion show is a part of her legacy. For Meg, fashion show was her senior prom. She strutted, not this runway, in the old Tewksbury High School, but she strutted the runway in the poofiest pink dress I've ever seen, and she looked absolutely beautiful. Since 2010, this fashion show has raised over $50,000 for the Megan McCarthy Research Fund. To date, Megan's legacy has raised over $800,000 for the Megan McCarthy Research Fund at Dana-Farber. Now, that number continues to grow every single year. Because of Megan, we are now able to provide funds for the groundbreaking research that doctors and scientists are doing at Dana-Farber. Each day, we are one step closer to finding a cure. Beyond the funds that she's raised, Megan has created a family of individuals that I am beyond thankful for. Some are actual family members of Megan's, others are friends, others started out as complete strangers. Each and every person who has ever interacted with Meg has his or her own memories and is a part of that family. For those of you who never got the chance to meet Meg, I truly am sorry. You missed out on meeting the most amazing person I have ever met in my entire life. I hope that me being here today and speaking about Megan has helped shine a light on who she was and the impact that she had on so many individuals. Megan's legacy will continue on through each and every one of us. So thank you so much for having me here tonight, and I hope you enjoy the rest of the show.
Of the season's part of the show. As Megan was very busy, she had lots of fun things she enjoyed through the year. Like as all teenagers, Megan enjoyed summertime, go to school, to hang out with her friends and go to the beach. And there was also school. She enjoyed skiing with her families on the weekends. They visited Utah, enjoyed many trips together. It was something she was able to do with her family. Now we welcome the Fashion of the Seasons.
You wanna ride in six? You want a dime and a six. When I leave with a kiss, you said I'll probably send you some bits. And I'm like, hell no, I'm waiting too long.
It's always great to get together with you, as I always say here, that we're here to, yes, remember Megan, but we're also here to celebrate her. So thank you for coming. I appreciate it, and all of our students appreciate it as well. So, a couple things, and I'm going to be very frank and honest with you here. All of our kids are now changing into their formal attire, so they said, all right, bring out the guy that talks the longest so that we have enough time to have the boys get into tuxes. The only problem with me being out here speaking is that I'll probably talk a little too long and they may get emotional again. And I blame Coach Edward for that because he's the one that taught me that years ago. But the boys don't have anyone back there showing them how to button their shirts and put the clips on their ties and how to get their ties. Like, they don't know how to tie a tie, and then they don't know how to clip it from the tuck. So I'm sure they'll get that squared away. A couple things. Somebody that's a good friend of mine that's even here, who's had a daughter that's come through the program and was an officer, and now has a son going through the program again as well, texted me today and said, well, what does DECA stand for? And today it doesn't stand for anything. Back when I was in high school back in 1988, DECA used to stand for Distributed Education Clubs of America. And it no longer stands for that. Today, DECA is an association of business and entrepreneurial students. DECA organization is their mission statement is that DECA is an organization that prepares emerging leaders and entrepreneurs in marketing, finance, hospitality, and management in high schools and colleges around the world. Our here at TMHS, we participate in community service projects such as this, the fashion show. We volunteered and donated our time with Tewksbury Youth Baseball, helping out working the concession stand there a couple times over the years. We help out with the bike rodeo that they host there in the high school, and we've helped out with the Rotary Club at the Taste of Tewksbury. So we do things within the community to help out. As far as DECA goes, our students participate at district, state, and international conferences. Our district conference is at UMass Lowell, which will be on January 12th this year. Our state conference, our UMass Lowell district conference is a one-day conference. Our state conference is a two-night, three-day conference in Boston at the Copley Sheridan, at the Copley Marriott, at the Sheridan. We use a couple of other hotels there. There's about 3,500 students and advisors at that state conference. And if students qualify in the top four or five at the state conference, they move on and they go to the international conference, which has been in places such as Anaheim, Orlando, Salt Lake City, Dallas, Louisville, Nashville, and this year, Atlanta. And we've been to Atlanta a couple times as well, where there are anywhere between 18 and 20,000 students competing worldwide. So DECA is a global organization that helps students that want to get into business. I will tell you that we have had significant number of students that have gone into business, but we've had a lot of students that leave here and go into nursing or go into other areas. And the experiences they get from participating in DECA, problem solving, figuring out a problem, talking to a judge, someone they don't know, or someone they've never met in life, is a life skill that they can't get anywhere else. And so those are all the benefits of DECA. You get to be part of a show like this that helps contribute to others. So that's kind of what DECA is. It doesn't stand for anything specifically anymore. So just to give you all an idea, those of you that have freshmen, everybody always, oh, I hear about DECA. I hear that it's a great program. So hopefully that gives you all some better ideas of what we do and what goes on and what takes place. That's the DECA piece of it. The other piece, again, I've already kind of touched upon Megan and her mom Lee being here, and Lauren, her best friend in high school, being here. Some of her former coaches have been here in the past, and I apologize. I don't know if Coach Ryan is here or if Coach Bradley are here today. I know I spoke with Coach McAndrews today as well, who couldn't say enough things about our students and thank me for continuing to do this. And he and I reminisced for a little bit about Megan and how much she meant to both of us in this school. And so Megan was special to all of us. She was special to every single person in the school. Everybody rallied around her. I can tell you emphatically as a young teacher back 12 years ago when this was all taking place, yes, I had been here 10 years, but someone had asked me, what did I learn from this whole experience? And I learned more from Megan in the time that I had her as a student in my class and someone that participated in this fashion show than I think I'd ever taught anyone in the classroom. You know, she was someone that knew what her station was and what was coming ahead of her. And I guess the one lesson that I would ask everybody to understand and to take away from tonight, other than, we're making a great financial contribution to the Jimmy Fund and to Dana Farber. And we've had a great night out here. We're going to finish up soon. And everybody's going to walk away going, wow, what a great night. And the kids did such a great job. And I'm not going to lie. I say the same thing. I coach the ball team. And people say, oh, congratulations. You had a great season. I just drive the van. And I know people don't believe that, but I just drive the van. The kids swing the clubs and do the work. It's not any different here. Mia, Ava, Jack, they drove the bus on this. Okay? I just kind of helped, I sat in the driver's seat, but they were the ones guiding us through this. And they did the work, and the kids followed through, and they did all that. I just put the loose pieces together and tie it together. So they're the ones that do all the work, and they deserve all the credit. So I thank you for that, but they're the ones that really deserve the credit. They're the ones, for those of you parents that don't interact with the greatest kids all the time, and people say, oh man, where's our world going? I want you to walk out of here and go, we're going to know that we're going in a good place. That we have kids like our students here at DMHS that are willing to give of themselves and do everything they've done to put on this night like tonight to remember Megan and to do for Megan. So, you hit that enough for me too. So, the last thing I want to leave you with is to remember about Megan. Never give up. Keep fighting and going forward. Live each and every day with joy and compassion. All right, Megan was and is the definition of Tewksbury tough, as she spent every day getting up, coming to school, going to practices, and doing everything she did and trying to help others as she knew what her fate was. So thank you all very much for coming. We appreciate it. We hope you enjoy the rest of the show.
I now want to introduce the moment that you all have been waiting for, the formal walk of the 2021 Megan McCarthy Fashion Show.
Thank you. Thank you.
this big one. Okay. As we wrap up the night, here is something we can all take away from the show this year. No matter how hard life seems, push through. There's always joy that can be found in doing what you love. For Megan, this was being with her friends and playing sports. But without her knowing, also a great role model, she is the reason that we are all here tonight.
We want to say thank you to everyone in the audience for attending the show tonight. All our models backstage helped, TMHS drama for the lights and the sound, and all of the businesses who donated. This night would not have been possible without all of you and your help. And a big thank you to Mr. Sullivan for overseeing this whole event and helping me, Via, Jack, and myself plan tonight. Let's give one last round of applause as our models take the stage for the last time in the 2021 Megan McCarthy Fashion Show.
I know you would've